Good evening. Welcome to our Thursday evening concert. If you are able, please stand and join us for the presentation of the colors by Boy Scout Troop 295, followed by the playing of our national anthem. Once again, thanks, boys, for coming out and doing this each week for us. Welcome to our concert titled The Beat Goes On. This music tonight's all of different dance styles, so if you feel like getting up and moving around, which you will be doing a little bit later, there's room in the aisles, there's rooms down front. We're going to start off with the song from the 1984 movie Footloose, starring Kevin Bacon and John Lithgow, about a young man who comes to a town in the Midwest where there's no dancing allowed. So here's Footloose.
Thank you.
written in 1927. The Red Poppy is a ballet by Reinhold Gluer. It's probably his best known work. Gluer was a Ukrainian composer who composed first during the Russian Empire and later as part of the Soviet Union. So this is the Russian sailors dance from Act Two, as the sailors are loading people onto a ship trying to rescue them from oppression in China. This is the Russian sailor dance. So good news or bad news, depending on your perspective, that's the only ballet this evening. We want to say thank you, as we always do each week, to our sponsors. You'll find their names inside your programs, local companies, corporations, foundations, and individuals just like you who help keep the music going here each week. If you're interested in becoming a sponsor, come up and see us afterwards, and we can take care of you with that. We're going to move on now with a piece of music by Leroy Anderson called Blue Tango. This was his first hit from 1951. So we've got some rock music, some ballet, a tango from Argentina. Our next piece of music was written just last year, and it was written by a composer, Robert Buckley, who wanted to pay tribute to the big band era of the 30s and 40s. So he kind of sampled different sounds from different big bands. He dedicated this to the King of Swing of Canada, because he's Canadian, so not dedicated to Benny Goodman. But he was trying to capture the feel of what it would have been like to dance the jitterbug. How many of you have ever danced the jitterbug before? Okay, there's plenty of space, right? Okay. So, this is Jitterbug. Thank you. All right, this is your first chance at audience participation. Is there anyone who doesn't know how to do the letters Y, M, C, and A with their bodies? I really don't want to have to demonstrate.
Oh, please do.
No, thank you. All right, so the YMCA dance craze actually originated on Dick Clark's American Bandstand in 1979. So you can either do it while you're seated or just stand up and join us for YMCA. Tito Puente was born in New York City, and he became known as the King of Latin Music. I got to see him perform when I was in college down at the Phrase, and it was amazing to watch him play, because imagine where I am if I was seated, and he had drums on the table in front of him, he had drums to his left, to his right, he had a giant arch above his head, he had all these different percussion instruments around him, and he played all of them. A great talent, sadly missed. This is a cha-cha he wrote that was made more famous, perhaps, by Santana. This is Oye Como Va.
Thank you.
the spirit. Very nice. Our next piece of music is a bit of a misnomer. Morton Gould wrote a lot of jazz charts in the 1940s and 50s for a radio show he did, and he called this movement from his American Symphonette a pavane. A pavane is a stately dance in two that dates from the Renaissance. It was only around for less than a century in terms of popularity, and yet this is a full-on jazz number. So this is our attempt at a pavane this evening. This is the pavane from the second American Symphonette by Morton Gould. Folgegestanz. Jawohl, yeah. Does anybody know what song this is? I deliberately did not put the English title on here. This is your next chance at audience participation. And it's a dance that you all, yes, see, they know, yes. This is a dance that you all can do. Interestingly, this song was written by a Czech composer shortly before World War II, and nobody knew it. And every country in World War II on all sides claimed that it was their song. That one of their composers wrote it. This is the chicken dance. Okay? So everybody can do the chicken dance. Join us. South of our border again. Our next song is a rumba. It comes from Cuba, written by Moises Simons. It's really a son peregon, is what they would call it, because it's based on the street cries of a seller in the streets. But in the 1920s, when it gained popularity, it was called a rumba. So that's why we stick with that today. And it got a second life in the 1940s and 50s when Stan Kenton used it as one of his jazz standards. This is the Peanut Vendor.
Thank you.
honestly, they're not plants. We didn't plant them out there. Thank you guys so much for dancing. Our next song is In the Stone by Earth, Wind & Fire, some funk music from the 1970s. This was a lesser hit for Earth, Wind & Fire, but became very popular with marching bands, and has had a whole new life in corps bands and university bands. And in fact, this is kind of an unofficial anthem for the University of Dayton. So this is the song that reminds us that love is written in stone. This is In the Stone. Drawing, so if you get your tickets out, you got when you came in at the door, Brendan's going to bring over the ticket basket. Again, we want to say thank you to both Susie's Big Dipper and Albrecht's for sponsoring these giveaways each week. We have a baker's dozen of donuts from Albrecht's and a gift certificate to Susie's. So we'll draw for the donuts first. And our ticket number is 620-273. 620-273, right up front. Okay. See if you sit closer. All right, and for the gift certificate to Susie's, 620. I think this is very similar to the last number. 271. Oh, third row. All right, we'll bring that down to you. Glenn Osser was an arranger of music for both Mercury and Columbia Records. And as a band person, I've been playing and conducting his works for a number of years, but I didn't know what else he did. He also arranged music for television, for movies, and he wrote the theme song for the New York Mets, Meet the Mets. Have you ever heard that tune? So again, every time you walk into New York, into the stadium at the Mets, you hear that song blaring through the speakers. This is one of his most famous pieces of music written for band. This is a beguine, and again, a South American dance, beguine for band. Moving a little bit closer to the present, in 2011, this song came out as a pop dance hit by a group called Maroon 5, and it was premiered on The Voice. Has anybody ever watched The Voice, the TV series? No? They try to turn people who have talent into pop singers that will get a recording contract. And so this song is about a young man who's trying to impress his girlfriend, and he thinks if he dances like Mick Jagger, he's going to win her over. This is Moves Like Jagger. Unless you want to get up and dance during Cats, this is your last chance for some audience participation. If you look inside your program, you'll find the words to the Beer Barrel Polka. And polka music is very popular in the United States as well, including in Cleveland, where you will find the Polka Hall of Fame. And this tune in particular is a staple of baseball games at Milwaukee, where the Brewers play it after Take Me Out to the Ball Game, every game at the seventh inning stretch. So when we get to the part to sing, and you know where it is, join in with the band and sing with us on the Beer Barrel Polka.
Thank you.
So a quick word about next week's concert. Next week's concert is entitled The Swingin' 60s. We're going to pay tribute to pop tunes, rock music from the 1960s, a salute to Woodstock, which we're celebrating the 50th anniversary of, coming here in August. We're going to hear some solos. We have a solo from Danny Elam within our band over there. Raise your hand and wave there, Danny. He's going to be playing a fantastic xylophone solo for you called Helter Skelter. And we also have, it's not that Helter Skelter, it's not the Beatles. I just realized, yes, no, sorry. Not the Beatles Helter Skelter. There will be no heavy metal music on, no, all right. And also we'll have some songs sung by Dr. David Severs from UD, who comes up and sings with us every now and then. He's going to sing Man of La Mancha and Cry Me a River for you next week. So it's going to be a great concert. Come on out, bring your friends. Hopefully the weather will be as good as it is tonight. We're going to close our concert before Stars and Stripes with selections from Cats by Andrew Lloyd Webber. This is a piece of a show that premiered in 1981 and features the words from Old Possum's book, A Practical Cats by T.S. Eliot, set to music, but really the show's all about the dancing. Seeing people who are wearing cat costumes with cat ears and long tails, basically jumping across the stage. So in this medley, you're going to hear music from The Overture, The Jellicle Songs for Jellicle Cats, The Old Gumby Cat, Memory, Mr. Mistopheles, and finally, The Addressing of Cats. Here are highlights from Cats.